My name is Austin, and there's something I've been wanting to talk about for quite a while. And it happens to do with something that many may be keen to or have hints upon, and I'd like to give my side of the story, I guess. So, what I'm talking about is something you can find well spread out through the field of philosophy, especially those that come into terms with metaphysical ideas and spiritual enlightenment. And it's this idea of oneness, of attainment, of enlightenment, of bliss, in a way. So, the thing I'm going to talk about today is the idea of duality. So, essentially, when it comes to what is and what is not, oftentimes we have a perspective that contrasts these, but far too often the middleman is taken out. And what I mean by that is, I mean, we recognize good, but we don't exactly see the connection good has to bad. And it's easy to understand on a basic level of, like, just seeing a spectrum, right? So, there's good, there's bad. There's truth, there is false. There's on, there's off. There's death, there's life. Excitement, fear, anxiety, so on and so forth. And the point I want to make about this topic in particular is, when it comes to understanding these to a level that is kind of ingrained, and I don't want to say that in the perspective that, you know, you have to be some monk or guru to actually understand or feel this contrast. But what I want to bring about and what I want to illustrate is this relationship in a much more pivotal way that can be expressed in anything you encounter in life. Anything. And this goes back to an idea that Alan Watts is kind of the individual I learned this from. And by me saying I learned, it's something I was able to experience myself through contemplation, pondering, you know, and effort being expunged into trying to get this. And what I ended up finding out is that when it comes to you, the individual, the identity, or the essence, there is a scope from which that individual obtains information from his environment. This information that he obtains is something that is not separate in the sense that there is the other. You know, it's not there is you and then there's something alternative to you. And this relationship emphasizes the significance of that statement. Because if you can see how good and bad are related, and then you transpose that into yourself and to what you make of the world, the only way of which you understand yourself is in an expression of, and conventional means, the other. So when I ask you who you are, what is your response?